Overlooking the Sea of Cortez and located along the slopes of the Cacachilas Mountains, Rancho Cacachilas incorporates an area roughly three times the size of the city of San Francisco. The terrain is rugged and covered in scrubby desert flora, dotted with cacti. Decomposing granite boulders feature prominently, shedding pebbles that are quickly eroded and ground first into kitty litter, then into sand. It's a tough environment for trail builders, which makes the experience of riding the single track through this extreme environment all the more special. The 9.1 kilometer Santa Rosa Trail, which took 18 months to build and is rumored to have cost nearly $1 million, was the first to be constructed at Rancho Cacachilas, with an assist from Shane Wilson and Mark McClure of IMBA's Trail Solutions Group. The ranch has its own 5-member year-round trail maintenance and build crew that is using the knowledge gained from working with IMBA to build out the rest of the trail network. The hope is to one day become an IMBA ride center once the 50-kilometer trail network is completed. The Santa Rosa Trail is truly impressive. After spending the better part of the morning riding twisty, mostly flat trails higher up, the descent down Santa Rosa was pure desert. The tight and at times abrupt corners, dusted with sand and gravel, gives way to a swoopy knife-edge ridgeline section where the ground falls away on either side. Just as quickly as it appears, the ridge disappears, and the trail compresses into a tightly wound coil of switchbacks. About halfway down, I get comfortable enough to let my rear tire slide across the sand-covered rock work in the corners, with my inside foot hovering just in case. On the other side of the ranch, the La Cruz Trail, which drops down into El Chivato Camp, offers proof that the Rancho Cacachilas trail crew wasn't interested in simply mimicking what they learned on the Santa Rosa build. Instead, they elevated the game. La Cruz is steeper and faster than Santa Rosa, with a more natural feel. The trail rolls over and through toddler-sized boulders, whose grippy and solid surface offers more pin and less spin than the other trails in the network. All of the climbing trails at Rancho Cacachilas are designed with a roughly 7% or less grade in mind. Any steeper and riders would find themselves spinning their rear wheels in the loose desert soil. Wooden trail armament is out of the question due to a voracious termite population. Instead, builders place massive shaped stones to prevent corners from being blown out and to slow the inevitable erosion. Where the trail crosses wide and sandy arroyos, large stones act as pavers to prevent riders from getting bogged down. From a distance, the foothills and mountains at Rancho Cacachilas appear dull and lifeless, but up close and on the trails, delicate flowers pop with purple, yellow, and red, while seemingly impossibly shaped cacti pierce the wind. Perhaps the most beautiful and unexpected find along the trail are the desert oases. A quiet trickle of water running above the sandy surface of an arroyo is enough to bring the desert to life. Towering palms mark the oases, where riders will find relief from the sun in the shady embrace of these tiny pockets of jungle. El Salto Trail offers particularly dramatic scenery and takes riders through a super lush desert oasis where the brief leafy canopy has riders momentarily widening their eyes, peering over top sunglasses to make out the trail in the relative darkness. Riding further out, the rockwork continues to impress. At one point, a rock bridge presents itself out of nowhere and then vanishes just as quickly as it appeared. A giant rock roll with a ride around can also be found on one of the more advanced trails. I counted about 24 miles or 39 kilometers of single track based on my rides, but numbers alone can be deceiving. Factor in all the short ups and downs, the imperfect climbing traction, and the potential for harsh desert conditions, and even strong riders will find their average speeds lower than expected. Riding all the single track in just one day would be a challenge for anyone. Realistically, most should plan on at least 2 days to explore all the trails by bike. The Rancho Cacachilas trails are accessible to guests and to day trippers who sign up for a guided ride at the Bike Hub, located in the small town of El Sargento. For $45 per person, riders get a shuttle from the town to the trail system, a guided trail ride, beer, and a meal prepared with locally sourced ingredients. The shop also rents mountain bikes for an additional $45 per day. Read more about the trails at Rancho Cacachilas at singletracks.com and visit the Rancho Cacachilas website at ranchocacachilas.com.